यस मैम। सो गुड आफ्टरनून मैम, माय नेम इज रॉबिन सिंह चौहान एंड माय टीममेट्स नेम इज अद्वैत काले एंड वी आर बोथ फ्रॉम श्री वैष्णव इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी इंदौर एंड टुडे वी आर हियर टू प्रेजेंट आवर प्रोजेक्ट विच इज नेम्ड एज टोंगो एंड सो हियर वी बिगिन। नेक्स्ट। सो एज आई इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ एंड माई टीममेट, सो हियर आर द टॉपिक्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू कवर। Our project name is Tongo. It is a mobile application. The objective of our project is basically that we offer solution to everyone. It is used for offline chat and online cloud storage. The scope is to provide basic functionalities using a mobile application. It will provide users access to offline chat within a range and also up to 100 megabytes of cloud storage for everyone, which can be further increased on a pay-as-you-go basis. The system architecture. So for developing the app, we use Flutter. Flutter, which is an open source mobile SDK, can be used to build native looking Android and as well as iOS applications from the same code base. For the backend, for the cloud storage, we have used Firebase as well as for the authentication. It is a software development platform and which was later acquired by Google in 2014. And this is the backend database which we are using. For authentication, we are using Google Authentication, so the user is not having to do much about his registration or login things. He just have to sign in with Google and he's good to go. For the offline chat application, the offline chat module, we have used Google Nearby Connections API, which uses your current location and some other stuff like creating a hotspot and etc. to transfer data from a mobile to another mobile. Next. Innovativeness. So Tongo does not use the traditional Wi-Fi hotspot, but we use Google's
flowchart se main kar dunga.
Okay. So we do not use the traditional Wi-Fi hotspot, but we use Google's new Nearby Connections API, which is more efficient in transferring data. It supports offline chatting like web-like, like torrent network, to communicate over distances without internet. It provides users with secure peer-to-peer communication. Message transfer are private and transfer encrypted from sender to receiver. Also, we provide 100 megabytes of free secure cloud storage for every user, which can later be increased, like I told earlier. Impact on society. The proposed system offers free cloud storage, like I told earlier, up to 100 megabytes. The offline chat functionality can be really useful in places if there is any kind of jammers or due to any emergency or any light outage due to which the connection is down. So the users will be able to chat and as well use other services of our application. In future, with a greater number of nodes and peer-to-peer network, this app could also be able to make its own private network on a bigger scale. So like you could actually have a whole society or maybe more than a society connected via without internet, but still connected to each other using the peer-to-peer network. The system overall offers many services in a single application, which makes our app very handy to use. Outcomes. So Tongo is the next step to wireless communication, the web of interconnected devices from a network of big enough to communicate through the network wirelessly and without internet. Tongo, when used on a major scale, can form a torrent-like network through which people can communicate and share files securely through 256-bit secure channel encrypted through peer-to-peer encoding using unique key for each user, creating it very hard to hack. Next. And now my colleague will explain the further flow.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Advait Kale. I am also from Sri Vaishnav Institute of Information Technology, Indore. And so let's move on to the flowchart of our project. Basically, this is the heart. We can say this is a short flowchart which has the application mapped up. First, we have the user login screen where we authenticate our user from Google Authentication. And then we have three gateways, which one is cloud storage, other is the share screen in which we can share any number of files offline or online. And lastly, there is the chat screen where we can chat both offline through multiple devices at a time through peer-to-peer connection. So let's get in detail with these things. The first login screen where Google authentication takes place. Then there is the cloud storage screen, where we are using Firebase storage currently, which permits, due to some limitations, it currently permits only 100 MB of per user storage. But when the application is in release phase, the cloud storage free access can be turned up to 1 GB per user, and then pay-as-you-go service will be applied to the cloud storage. Then comes the share screen. In the share screen, we have a similar UI like Zender or any other apps, but the benefit of this Tongo application is that it uses the latest technology other than creating Wi-Fi hotspot or any other thing. It uses nearby connection API, which uses your device's Bluetooth service, location service, and if your device has an NFC enabled, then it also uses the NFA service for secure data transmission through multiple devices in a peer-to-peer connection or star topology. Then this is the offline chat screen, in which we can connect multiple devices. Right now, in this screenshot, I have connected only single device for the chat because of device limitations. So if we have more than two devices, then we can connect multiple devices through here, and it can be used as a broadcast service as an emergency too. So all the nearby connected devices in an emergency situation or any other case, there can be broadcasted to all the devices nearby. So now we come to the limitations. Tongo can currently only provide 100 Mbps of free storage, but later on we are planning on providing a 1 GB free storage and then pay-as-you-go service as low as 10 rupees per GB. And currently the range of the devices are limited because the range depends on number of devices which has installed Tongo. So if we have around 1,000 or 10,000 devices which are running Tongo, so the peer-to-peer star technology will be used, and there will be multiple connected devices through a web, so we can transmit data from one device to another device securely through SHA-256 hash, and we can communicate without directly connecting but through third party like torrent network. So in future work, we are planning on providing more storage to the users. The Firebase scalability is also be provided. In initial stage, in cloud storage, currently we are only accepting document files like doc file, PDF file, or any other digital signature files. But in later stages, when the storage is increased, we can provide all sorts of files, images, and other things. In future, online chat, online files sharing, and offline and online application usage will also be provided. Thank you. So this is our cloud authentication, where we can authenticate the users through cloud and Google authentication. So firstly, we have our cloud storage screen here. Currently, I have uploaded two files in it. So we have 1.82 MB used, around 100 MB above free storage. We can upload our documents or delete our documents through cloud storage screen. And in the release phase of the application, we will plan on delivering 1 GB of storage. So we can upload our files from here. Any files or media files do we have on document format? So we can upload directly from here. And also, this is the chat screen, which contains the username, and there are three options where we can choose. The first option is host, the second option is receive. So the host creates a wide area network connection, and the receivers will receive this connection to the host. So it will form either peer-to-peer connection using star topology. So every user is connected to individually to the application of the host. So there is no data data security issue in this. So if I click the host, so we can see that the status is hosting. So if I connect my other device as a receiver, then we will instantly get a device detection message that this device is detected. Do you want to connect? So So this is the video demonstration where in one device we have Santosh Kale, we have hosted the application, and when we click receive, we get instantly get a request connection. When we accept both connections on devices, we get the users connected. So now we can offline, we can chat without internet through
so
offline.
Can we connect multiple users in a single?
Yes, we can connect multiple users. Currently, due to device limitations, I only had two devices at that time when I recorded. So if I have multiple devices, like I have to connect another device, so I will click receive on that device. So it the device will detect that the host is active and we can connect to the third device. It will act like a star connection. So if in a wide case scenario, if we think that there are 10,000 devices in an area, so if device A is connected to device B is connected to C, and C is connected to D. So we can transfer data from A to D through SHA hash functions individually from user, created from user. In Google authentication, we get a unique user ID for each user. So that user ID will be used for hashing this 256 SHA key, and we can share data from one device to another device securely through this connection. So if we have a wide web of device connected, we can transfer data from one device to another without internet. It is like a peer-to-peer solution for mini internet.
Maximum number of users कितने हो सकते
हैं? मैम, maximum number of users according to the processor limitations depend होगा, क्योंकि अपना अगर multiple processor devices से connected है, क्योंकि हमारा Bluetooth BLE technology use होता है, Bluetooth low energy, and our NFC if used. So if the devices are more than like 50 around, so maybe it can create an issue like system lag or something, because multiple devices connected, so Bluetooth has to connect with these many of the devices, manage them in the application. So that is the limit.
Okay.
Also, the application size will be around 7 to 8 MB when in release mode.
इसे सिक्योरिटी के हिसाब से क्या सोचा आप लोगों ने? कुछ है सिक्योरिटी का कुछ पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू यहाँ पे?
यस सर, सिक्योरिटी क्योंकि हम पीयर टू पीयर कनेक्शंस यूज कर रहे हैं, और अगर हम वाइड एरिया में इम्प्लीमेंट करें इसको, तो हमारा डेटा जो है वो अगर फोन ए बी से कनेक्टेड है, बी सी से कनेक्टेड है, हमको ए से सी जाना है, तो हमको बी के थ्रू जाना पड़ेगा. तो देर इज अ स्लाइट चांस ऑफ डेटा गेटिंग मॉनिटर्ड और स्टोलन फ्रॉम बी. सो फॉर दैट एक्चुअली आई कैन शो यू दैट. वन सेकेंड, कैन आई शो यू द हैश दैट वी आर यूजिंग? Yes. So these are the currently the test alpha testing users we have on the application. So you can see that each user is assigned a unique UID for their account. These unique UIDs are used for hashing the data from by using 256 SHA key, which is currently the most secure and unhackable. So this we will create a digital signature like public key and a private key. Private key will be with the user, which will be hashed by this unique ID for each user, and the public key will be provided for authentication of the data. So data cannot be encrypted without private and public keys, but data can be accessed only through the unique public key provided by the network. This is the user ID, unique user ID provided to each user. Currently we have alpha testing, we have 4 users on the application. So each user is assigned a unique UID. We can use this UID to encrypt the hash data function, so we can transfer the data securely through multiple devices, and data cannot be hacked between devices because the data will be encrypted by public and private keys. So the intermediate devices will not receive a key, so they cannot decrypt the data which is traveling through it. So it cannot be hacked.